He's an analyst for the Yes Network, the Yankees Network, the former Red, former Yankee. He's Paul O'Neill joining us on the show. Paul, how are you this morning?
Dan, how are you, man? Nice in Ohio today, I'll tell you that.
Well, that's nice. Are you playing golf today?
I'm actually on my way as we speak.
That's what I thought. When you called in earlier, I thought, okay, Paul's got a tee time here.
Pretty good.
Most famous person you've golfed with is who?
Michael Jordan, I would say.
How'd that go?
I mean, it's always awesome. I mean, that's one guy that I don't care what line of work you're in, athlete, broadcast, any, you're in all of. So that probably takes the cake.
But you're a competitor. He's certainly a competitor. How's that go with trash talking?
Anytime that you get an opportunity to just speak and talk to people like that, you just kind of, like I said, you kind of stand back. There's not a lot of people in sports that, you know, you do that with, but there's an aura about Michael Jordan. There's no doubt about it.
We were talking about celebrations, that when do you celebrate? How much do you celebrate? Do you celebrate if you get in winning the wild card? You win the divisional series, obviously the World Series. Was there any set rules with the Yankees of how much you celebrated when you guys would win?
Well, I don't think you ever take it for granted. I think that, every time, every round, you do celebrate, but you celebrate in the anticipation of celebrating the last time after the World Series. I think that, celebration in the middle of the year over a home run or this and that, sure, it's great to have fun and you need that, those up moments, but, it all goes about, the culture of winning and where you are, of how much you do celebrate at certain times.
Well, I think if you have a payroll over $180 million, you shouldn't be able to celebrate till you win the World Series. Is that fair?
Well, I think that in spring training, you definitely go with a different mentality. But there's more teams that are on that level now, and I think that most people are starting to realize that because you have a huge payroll doesn't always guarantee championships. A lot of things have to go well, and you have to have the right people in order.
Why is it that we call the Yankees the evil empire, but when the Dodgers spend over $200 million, people don't look at it the same way they do with the Yankees?
Didn't that evil empire, didn't that kind of come from the Boston Nation up there? I mean, isn't that because they kind of resented the Yankees winning? I don't know, but they got kind of in the same boat, too. So, the big markets obviously have opportunities to, spend more money. But, again, it doesn't always put you in a perfect position to win championships year after year.
He's Paul O'Neill, the Yes Network, joining us, Dan Patrick Show. Saw where you have an interest in managing the Reds. Fair?
Well, I mean, it's fair. I mean, anytime that some things just come about, it interests you. And, I mean, you're from Ohio. I mean, you grew up here in the 70s where, the big red machine and the tradition of Cincinnati needs to be brought back. And, it was a rebuilding process. Would I be interested? Probably not nearly as much because, I mean, this team is very good. This team has an opportunity to win. And, competing when you're a retired player, really the only competing you have is either on the golf course or you get back into baseball and managing. So do I enjoy what I do in the broadcast booth? Absolutely. But like I said, every once in a while you see opportunities that just seem like, boy, that would be really, really cool. And, I don't know where this is going to go, but sure. I mean, if it was talked about or I had an opportunity to sit down with Mr. Gasolini, I would definitely be interested in managing this team because I think this team can win, and that's basically what it's all about.
Have you heard from the Reds?
Well, I've talked to some people in the organization, obviously. I live here in Cincinnati, but, I don't think they'll do anything. This is a kind of the prize time of baseball for fans to sit back and watch the playoffs and try to keep other things out of the news.
When you get to the championship series, National League, American League, we always talk about pitching, the importance of pitching. If you're going to handicap, the American League with the Red Sox and the Tigers, would you start with the pitching?
Well, I mean, the Red Sox have played so well, and they're such a, you look at them, they really don't have weaknesses because they score runs, they have great pitching, they've got guys in the bullpen. Detroit has had somewhat of an issue, but, you have Verlander, you see what he can do from last night. So, again, both teams have that belief that they can win because they have won. And that's very strong when it comes to these big series. But I always felt like, you know, the first series, there's so much pressure on you because you have to get through that first series. And then it almost builds into this series because you're getting so close to the World Series. And, you know, it's just very important as a team not to just show up and play into these series and see who's going to win. But, you know, you have to go out from pitch one and win these games because momentum is so huge in these short series.
Everybody talking about Verlander, Kershaw. I mean, it seemed Wainwright, Waka. You have these guys. The headlines have been these pitchers. Who was the pitcher you ran into that was just lights out, you know, postseason time? They were just took it up another notch.
Well, I mean, you look back at 2001, and we ran into Schilling and Randy Johnson. I mean, it made it very tough. But if you look at it, we had that series won except for a fluke hit. But, you know, in the years that we were playing Atlanta, you know, you're facing Maddox and Smoltz and Glavine and guys like that. So seldom do you face guys in the championship series and the World Series that you're very comfortable hitting off of, because those days are over. You're facing the best pitching, and your opportunities to score runs in big games are much less, and you have to take advantage of those. And that's kind of the nerve-wracking thing as a player going into these huge games, is you don't know who's those one or two guys that are going to have those huge at bats. You know, you do all the hypotheticals. If it's going to be me in the eighth inning, who will I be facing? And you try to set up these at bats and get ready for them because, you know, there's special guys that you face in those big times in the late in the game.
You got 5 World Series rings?
Yeah.
Which
yeah.
one?
Thought
do you...
I had 6. Thought I had 6 in Arizona, but, you know, but a little blue pit does that sometimes.
Wait, does that bother you more that instead of celebrating 5, you're regretting? You know, you're bummed about the one you lost?
No, absolutely
oh, okay.
not.
I mean, do you wear a World Series ring?
No, I don't. But they every once in a while, you walk by a trophy case and you look in there and you just wonder and you look and you understand how fortunate you were to be part of you know, great teams. And it just, you know, people have great careers, but you know the teams that are remembered. I mean, there was a celebration here last week about the Great Eight, the Big Red Machine, and that's what people remember. They remember championships, not, you know, great individual years.
The career of Jeter, the career of Rivera on the field, which one would you take?
You know what? That's a tough question. I mean, those guys I have more respect for than anybody. I mean, Mariano, the way he went about his business, Derek Jeter, his ability to come up big at all times. I mean, that's why, you know, the Yankees in the late 90s, those runs that those teams went through, that's why it happened. It just wasn't a fluke. I mean, there were great players, great teams, great manager. It all came together. And you kind of took it for granted when we were going through it, but you realize how hard it is to do now.
You didn't answer.
I thought I kind of ran around the question.
You sounded like a manager there.
You know what? I'll take either of them. How's that?
No, you take Jeter because he plays every day. Mo's great.
You know what? I was an everyday player, and I don't know that you know, pitchers understand what it takes to play every single day, and vice versa. But you know, I look at what Jeter did for the Yankees, and I also look at World Series, and I don't think we'd have won the World Series without what Mariano did as a closer. So. Like I said, it's very hard to explain, but I definitely am on the side of the everyday players. You're right.
Have fun golfing. Good luck if the opportunity presents itself with the Reds. Thank you, Paul.
Dan, have a good one.
All right, that's Paul O'Neill.
The Dan Patrick Show, weekday mornings on Audience.